Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are live, ladies and gentlemen. It is Wednesday, the 16th day of February 2011. We're going to be here live for the next 3 hours. We're going to be talking about activism and the political awakening happening all across the world with Luke Rudkowski, founder of We Are Change, in the last hour today. In the meantime, there is a just massive amount of vital news and information that we're going to be covering. And in the first hour, I want to have open phones for first-time callers only. In the second hour, it will be a complete and total free-for-all for everybody. Love to hear from all of you. Any issue or item you want to discuss, first-time callers, 800-259-9231. Obviously, there have been big new developments in the Middle East continuing to unfold. The Suez Canal worker staged sit-in as U.S. warships are dispatched and Marines prepare to enter the country. Presidential Medal of Freedom given to former President George H.W. Bush and 14 others. Why not give a Medal of Freedom to Stalin? Continuing, U.S. agents are shot, one killed in Mexico. This out of the Wall Street Journal. But Big Sis is busy now rolling out at the NFL with brainwashing messages about not trusting your fellow citizens, only trusting government, the NBA, Major League Baseball, you name it, just a complete rollout, trying to basically have the TSA be seen as some type of messianic rock stars or movie stars. Meanwhile, the security situation continues to deteriorate in Mexico. We're going to be going over that as well today. We're going to look at some positive news from Rand Paul continuing to deliver on his promises. He wants a $500 billion cut. He's supporting his father in the audit of the Fed, and he is promising to try to block the reauthorization in the U.S. Senate of the USA Patriot Act. So he is certainly delivering on what he promised to do. And that leads us into Congressman Ron Paul. The first thing I'm going to cover when we come back is not just Rand Paul, but Ron Paul. Fox News has been caught in an extremely wicked, dirty trick. And there really should be some repercussions for this. If they did something deceptive like this on someone I don't like Barack Obama or Dick Cheney, I would be screaming and hopping up and down concerned. But they did this to Ron Paul. Of course, they wouldn't do this to Dick Cheney or Barack Obama or a fellow globalist. They would only do this to somebody like Ron Paul. They have been caught absolutely red-handed playing video reportedly of Ron Paul being booed at CPAC. And it's a lie. It's a fraud. It's a fake. And we're going to break that down the other side. And they are admittedly caught. They have admittedly been dinged. When I saw this last night, I couldn't believe it. I actually went to cspan.org. They have all of it archived there for free, the audio and video of it, and did go to the video where they announced the winner of the CPAC coveted poll to Ron Paul. Unbelievable standing ovation. All you hear is just thunderous applause. If you watch Fox News, it's complete and total booing. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, this is outrageous. And you know who runs Fox News? It's the Karl Rove slash Roger Ailes arm of rhino neocons who pose as conservatives so they can control the conservative movement in this country that threatens the New World Order, period. This is so important, and I'm going to break it all down on the other side. Then, USA Today, kill switch internet bill, alarms privacy experts, and so much more. We'll tell you what the latest from Bernie Madoff saying the big banks had to know what he was doing. Of course they did. It is all coming up today. Stay with us.
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones asking you for a minute of your time to tell you about soap. Not detergents, but good old-fashioned pure soap made by the Calbin Soap Company, a family-owned and operated American company. My family, staff, friends, and radio listeners are constantly telling me how much they love these products for bath, hair, laundry, and dishes. There is nothing like these factory-direct, big-money-saving, triple-concentrated soaps anywhere. Get a free detailed catalog by calling 800-340-7091 or see them online at 5starsoap.com or Infowars.com. Let's talk to the owner of 5 Star Soap, Marty Schachter, and see what he has to say.
As founder and owner for over 63 years, people keep asking me, how's business? I'm happy to say our business is going down the drain. Call us at 1-800-340-7091. Visit our website, 5starsoap.com, for buying our 1 to 2 month soap sampler. Thank you.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Wednesday, the 16th day of February, 2011. Thank you for joining us. USA Today headline, kill switch internet bill alarms privacy experts. How about people that want to have free speech in this country? We're going to be going over that report. Also, parents blame toddler's death on tainted alcohol wipes. Millions of pad swabs recalled because of same bacteria that killed two-year-old. Bernie Madoff in my financial stack from CNBC. From prison, Madoff says banks had to know of fraud. Of course they did. They were deeply involved in all of it. Also, they've been reporting that Hosni Mubarak was in a coma or dead the last 3 or 4 days. Now they say that he is reportedly near death. In Egypt, first they'd said that he'd been in Israel for the last, 4 or 5 days, or I guess longer, since Friday. No one really knows where he is. So I guess that's almost 6 days. We're going to be going over all of that, continuing with our look at North Africa and the Middle East. The Suez Canal workers stage sit-in as U.S. warships have been dispatched. We're going to be breaking that down today. But I also want to just give you the note that Gerald Celente will be joining us coming up in the last 30 minutes of the broadcast on the economy and the revolutions that are popping up worldwide, driven by increased food prices via dollar devaluation and other factors. And Luke Radowski will also be joining us for 30 minutes to talk about his incredible confrontation of Dick Cheney at CPAC. Now, mentioning CPAC, I do not have words to describe how naked the corruption of Fox News is. And you know I criticize MSNBC. I criticize CNN. These groups all basically have goals via the establishment to suppress the population's political awakening and to basically play the population of the United States off against each other. And that is clearly what is happening today. CNN is more to an international audience and tries to play the middle as if they're nonpartisan. MSNBC is filled with extreme kind of fake left vitriol and race baiting. If you don't like government-run health care, then you are a racist. If you don't give up your guns, you're a racist. And then you look at Fox News. What is Fox News there for? They're rhinos. They're Republicans in name only. It is their job to suppress and to control the libertarian slash conservative movement in this country that at its roots threatens the globalist agenda of one world government, cashless society, control grids, global SDRs, the Patriot Act, the surveillance grid, the military-industrial complex takeover of this country. So the Democrats bought and paid for by the same offshore slash Wall Street interest. They're there to put out a political narrative that is attractive and manipulative towards people that see themselves as leftists. Fox News is there to kind of keep Republicans on the mainline fake plastic conservative front. And they're also there, of course, to continue that left-right paradigm, balkanization, division that we talk so much about. Now, illustrating this is the fact that for decades, Rush Limbaugh, and for the last decade or so, Fox Television, Fox News, have made endless jokes about people that are worried about a police state. People that don't like the private Federal Reserve, people that criticize the Council on Foreign Relations, when all of these organizations openly are pushing for world government, and true patriots that are aware of this threat have been covering it and trying to warn the people. So for as long as they could, Fox News tried to paint anyone that talked about real issues with a tinfoil hat paintbrush. But in the last 3 or 4 years, there have been so many AP and Financial Times of London and Newsweek and Time magazine articles and so many open announcements by the G20 and the United Nations that indeed a private world government is being established, that indeed a system of planetary corporate rule is being created, that indeed a program of forced world population